How do you pronounce silicon?
Here's what I found.
Apple silicon.
Apple silicon.
Apple silicon.
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 So the A4 chip.
Silicon.
If you're an artist or a designer, or a digital media creator, or a gamer, or a developer, you may depend on applications that only run on Microsoft Windows. And if you're a loyal Mac user, you may have been using Apple Boot Camp to be able to install Windows on your Mac and use it for all kinds of magical things over the last many years that Apple has supported Windows on its Intel-based Macs. Since Apple switched from PowerPC processors to Intel processors, they have supported this functionality. I know many Apple users who depend on CAD applications that only run on Windows, and they swear that they love macOS, and they love Apple hardware, and they run Windows reluctantly. Unfortunately, that's all about to change. With the release of Apple Silicon, the next generation of Apple laptops will be using Apple's own processors, based upon the design of the processors that have made the iPhone and the iPad a true success in the marketplace. In a nutshell, if you're an artist or designer who has been depending on Windows 10 applications running on your Macs, you will no longer be able to do so on Apple's new silicon chips. This is not the first time that Apple's been through this transition, and I personally went through the last transition from PowerPC to Intel. They will not support Boot Camp because they will not be running Intel processors. Apple's current laptop lineup is using Intel processors of various generations. The same goes for their desktops. However, at the Worldwide Developer Conference, Apple announced their transition plans to move to Apple Silicon. App makers have already started to transition their applications to Apple Silicon, including Adobe, where a demo of Adobe Photoshop was shown in the WWDC keynote. There are a ton of upsides for Apple to make this move. First of all, it means that they will be able to control their own schedule for releasing chips. It will mean that they'll be on the same platform for iPhones, iPads, and Macs. And they will be able to tightly integrate their operating system with the chips to tune performance. The downsides is that if you're dependent on Windows applications, there does not appear to be a way to run these applications competently on Apple Silicon. They will not be able to natively support Boot Camp. And secondly, they will not be able to support Windows under virtualization because currently Microsoft only licenses Windows for ARM processors to OEMs, meaning you as a consumer cannot purchase Windows for ARM processors. So what to do? The current generation of macOS machines are running Intel processors. So if you absolutely must have a machine that can run Windows Boot Camp, seriously consider purchasing a MacBook Pro or other Apple hardware now while it still has an Intel processor. They're making a great lineup of machines, and I'm sure that you'll really enjoy using that hardware in the years to come. Secondly, you won't be a first generation user of Apple Silicon. I remember when I was a student, I was very reluctant to change my setup of my creative workflow on my computer because it just meant that something might not work. My dad was constantly upgrading his computer and doing all kinds of wild things, and sometimes things didn't work and he was okay with that, but I wasn't. And you as a student might not be keen on that either. However, sometimes fortune favors the bold and you might enjoy actually trying out a new thing. Another upside is that some of the early test results from the Apple developer kits, Apple Silicon performance is absolutely spectacular. The second benefit is that iPad and iPhone apps can be ported to macOS Big Sur with very little modification. So it will open up a whole new horizon of applications that you can run on macOS that you've historically used on iOS. Regardless, it's an exciting change, and I look forward to all the new things that Apple comes out with. I also look forward to all the things that artists and designers are going to create with these new products. I hope you found this information useful. There's lots of great information out there on the internet that can inform your decision-making, and I wish you all the best.
Silicon.
Seems to be a difference of opinion there. What time does Dollarama close?
Dollarama on Danforth Avenue is open today from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m.
Dollarama.